When I got into teaching, I wanted to be the perfect teacher. And then I actually started teaching. I ran myself ragged, making sure every unit, every lesson was engaging and fun for my students. I chaperoned every dance, never said no when asked to do something by administration or other teachers. I was calling home to parents every day, tutoring students before and after school. I was reading teacher books, doing nightly teacher Twitter chats. I refused to call in sick and I would hack my way through lessons. I was striving for perfection. And after about 3 years of this, I burned out. But then a teacher who'd been doing this for a really long time, like 40 years and still loved the work, said something to me I'll never forget. She said, "You don't have to be perfect." I responded, "Yeah, but no, you don't have to be perfect." Well, I said, "But I want to change lives and I want to make my class memorable." And she said, "Me too, but you don't have to be perfect to do that." I let her words sink in and sit with me, and then I decided to start over. Well, nowadays, I sometimes lose my patience with kids, and I sometimes run out of good ideas, and students have to learn about the French Revolution from reading a book, and class can be a little boring at times, and sometimes that pile of papers I have to grade gets taller and taller and taller. And you know what I've found? You don't have to be perfect to get to know your students and build relationships with them. Perfection isn't required to make your class memorable and even fun. Heck, sometimes it won't be memorable and fun, and that's okay. Kids still learn and grow and fail and succeed in my imperfect class. I mean, I still strive to do my best and always get better at what I'm doing, but I know that I'm never going to be perfect, and so I don't have to carry the weight of trying to be. And with that weight gone, I find I'm a lot freer to be a better teacher.